Okay. What I want is total of 4 feet sticking out of the ground and 2 feet of this post, or 2 foot in the hole buried in concrete. So you gotta take some measurements here. Let's start out. And 4 foot marks this right here. And then another 2 feet brings us to 6. It's gonna be right here. 6 foot. So this is what I'm gonna cut. Get a nice line across here, sides. Okay, got our mark for now. Next step is to cut. We need to make sure that we're locked in here and we're not going to move. This is set at 0 degrees, so we know we're going to get a nice right angle. And with that, make sure we're all aligned. Go ahead and start our cut. There's the first one. Sure, you can still see this. And there we go, we have our 6x6 post set to the right height. Next step is gonna be to cut the horizontal. Okay, for a horizontal, taking measurements, we got 17 inches that the mailbox is gonna take up, because it takes about here, plus another 6 inches for the 4x4 post, plus 10, I get a total of 33. So, we're gonna need to make our cut. Right at 33 inches here. So just measuring that out and do the same thing we did before. Nice line. Cut. Thank you. And we have the spot for our mailbox cut. Horizontal piece, 33 inches. Okay, using this for illustration, this is not our vertical post, but let's say it was set into the ground. This is the top. This end down here would be in the ground. This piece here is our horizontal piece. Our mailbox is gonna fit here. And then we'll have a little tail coming out the end just to give it a more balanced look. Catch with this is we don't want it sitting up here, we want to set it in flush. So to do so, we're going to have to cut a notch in here. And we're going to notch this basically up like this and over, and we'll cut a notch in this side. It comes down on the bottom, and the two will fit together, and we'll have a nice sandwiched flush 6x6 in width mailbox holder. So that's the next step. Okay, a couple of changes here before I get going. Our 33 inch horizontal piece, I cut a little angle here because the front of the mailbox is going to sit here, and I just didn't want to have a blunt piece of wood just sticking out there. So, our mailbox is going to sit here. We need our vertical post to be sitting here. So let me grab that real quick. This guy's going to sit right in here. And then we'll have a little tail sticking out the end. Okay, so we need to cut a notch, like I said, in both pieces of wood so that they'll fit together. So if you look carefully here with my score and everything, I have notched out or sketched out where our notch is going to be coming back on this side. We're going to cut out this chunk of wood here. So we got, it's actually 15-16 inches deep to marry these two. They're almost 6x6s together. So we're going to do this one, then we'll do the vertical post next. To do this, I'm going to have to lay it down on the ground and use a circular saw. The circular saw is not going to quite get it. It's going to come down here. The max I get out of the circular saw is about 2.5 inches. So we're going to have a little bit of work to here to do afterward by hand, but that'll get us started. I'm going to cut, we'll get set up for the circular saw. Okay, we got set up here. I got the circular saw in the background there. These blocks of wood on the side I'm just using to help kind of reinforce the wood as I'm pushing against it with the circular saw. And we're going to use that circular saw to start cutting some 2.5 inch grooves in there to start our notch in the wood. So I'm going to go ahead and do that now. Thank you. Okay, at this point I have measured and set up our vertical post with the same notch in it. Actually, I found that my power miter saw actually makes a deeper cut, so I'm actually going to use this to notch it out this time around. This is all lined up, looking good. There's actually a stop over here on the power miter saw, so you can actually stop it at the right depth. Okay, the next step on our process here is we've got these half-inch bolts that we want to put through here. We need to drill some holes for it. I don't want the bolt head sticking out above the surface of my vertical post. So we're going to counter drill a little hole for the washers and the head of the bolt. And then we've got a half-inch long drill bit to actually go straight down through and come out the other end. We do the other end, we're going to do the same thing. We're going to drill that out and give ourselves a little space for the head of the nuts. So with that said, Milwaukee drill, the spade bit on here. This is 1.5 inch, which is large enough for our washers. I've already marked out our spots here, centered, so we know where to go. Inside there, like that. Next step is going to drill our holes. Our main holes. So we're going to take this guy out of here. And thank you. Okay, now I gotta get our level, make sure we have our truth.